We are back here at the Taichung HSR. We're going to take the HSR back to Taipei and spend the remaining days there until we go back to Singapore.
We're finally here at Taipei and we have checked into the hotel. So this is a Hanshe Business Hotel.
Yeah, I'm quite happy with the hotel. Actually, prior to this, right, when I look at the picture of the hotel, it looked kind of underwhelming, right? So far, after checking in, yes, it exceeded my expectation. Yeah, the room is clean, toilet is decently big, you know. My roommate is using the toilet now, can't really show. Then, bed is okay too, right? Yeah, so great. So we just left the hotel, right? We're gonna check exploring Ximending now. Free and easy. Yeah, it's a bit drizzling right now. Weather is a bit shook though, not cooling. So we are going to this cooling store called
Net, right? According to my friend, it's a bit like Uniqlo but like cheaper. So let's see what good stuff I can pick up. I bought a outerwear and a belt. And we visit the Animate store in Taipei, supposedly in this building. Then there's a 7-Eleven here that is a theme, right? Kind of cute. The Holy Grail of manga, right? Maybe someday I'll collect the whole collection in my own room. This is where we'll be having dinner. Right, so it's kind of raining right now. Right, raining, dark sky, so we're not too sure whether we want to pay the money to go up all the way to the top to see the view. Because I think it won't be that nice. The sky is not really clear and I think it will ruin the experience. But we'll see. Also change of plans, right? What we're going to do now, right, is we come back another day. But we got more time. What we're gonna do is we'll try to go to the Sky Tower at around when it's about the sunset and just chill there until the sun sets and all the city light turns on. So the view will be nicer lah compared to all these gloomy day. So right now we are gonna proceed to the Kukong. It's like a traditional Taiwanese Structure Museum.
National Palace Museum.
So now we're gonna go and buy the tickets. And I heard, not sure how true it is, but if you are Chinese, they charge cheaper. But I don't know how true is that. That is. So I need to speak in Chinese. Right? I need to straight away call the person 大哥. Or 美女, 我要买票, or some shit.
帅哥,
帅哥, 美女, 我要买六份票,
六张,
okay, I guess I need to pay extra. Oh yeah, I knew it was kind of weird, right, when my friends told me that there's a chance really if you are Chinese, it's cheaper, but they mean is if you are the Taiwan citizen, they charge you cheaper. So it's the same in Singapore, right? It's not the Singapore Museum. If you are like the Singapore citizen, you get going for free. Today we are gonna head to Jiufen and Shifen. We booked the rental car, right, to drive us around for like, I think it's like a full day, right? 8 hours, we booked it on Klook. So it's a really big car, right? You can see like, I believe like 8 to 9 people. So if you are gonna go to Jiufen or Shifen, it will be a good idea to book a car. Our next stop after Jiufen is the Shifen waterfall.
Smaller waterfall.
So there's a map right there.
Yep, this is the Shifen waterfall. We are gonna check out the waterfall. And the next stop after the waterfall is to go to the part where there's the very popular the train run.
We are at the second part of the Shifen. This is where we do the lantern, and this is where the famous spot whereby there's the train track in the middle. I can see the lanterns are like there. Let me show you all. So right now we are writing on the blue section. The first one is 老板 Jia Xing is asking the boss for a raise. Then this one is what? 6个月什么啊?
奖金 bonus.
Oh, just asking for bonus. And the third one is 工作顺利, so like blessing, smooth career progression. Fourth one is 不用加班, no need to OT. Then last one is 尽快升职, means faster promotion. Yeah. We are here at Ningxia Night Market and we found somebody's passport. And we are gonna try to like, we found somebody's passport, man. This is we are gonna try to find the nearest police station and return it there. So we are here today at Xingbeidu. This is like a 1 hour MRT ride from Taipei Ximending to get here. So this place is famous for the hot spring and onsen. And compared to Ximending, right, this place is a bit more serene and quiet. There's this like, once you get off the station, you'll be greeted with this small museum explaining the history of Ximbeidu. You can see this like decommissioned railway here, kind of cool. And they have, I especially like the colors of the trees right here at the moment. It's really nice. This is sort of like a semi-free and easy day for us. Kind of split up into two groups, right? And I decided to spend today to get souvenirs. So I went to this place. I didn't really vlog because my hands are kind of tight, right, while I was there. The place was at Dongmen. It's maybe like a 20-minute MRT ride from Ximen. They sell this really nice almond snack there that I read about. And I tried their some samples. It was really good, right? So I bought like 10 packs. I will put a picture of the location here for y'all to refer. The place is really nice. Dongmen is not as crowded as Ximen. So, and that place has a lot of like, gives a really feel of Japan, right? The streets are small, the roads are small, this kind of stuff. I would recommend to get souvenirs there. The souvenirs there are more unique and different from Ximen thing, right? Especially key change, pouches, all this kind of stuff, and of course, the almond snack, right? I think it's highly recommended. If you want to queue very long for souvenirs, Dongmen is a good place to get your souvenirs at. So now I'm just gonna walk back to my hotel and unload all these back in the hotel and meet my friends at the Taipei 101 for the view. Got my camera set up to shoot a time lapse of the sunset. Right. This is where you have two cameras would be good. So you can just chill here, use your phone and wait for the sun to set and all the city lights to light on. It's the second last day. We are here and we're going to start off by having a Michelin star beef noodle that is like literally 90 meters, 50 meters from our accommodations. So after the lunch, right, I went off my separate way. Here at Zhongshan. So supposedly here there's I read an article that there's quite a lot of thrift store, UK store around here, so I'm gonna go check it out.
So I saw like a old toy pal here, like one for 60 to 100, and I found this really like skeleton family which I thought was kind of funny and cute, so I bought them from this vintage camera store.